Good luck.
Good evening and welcome to the closing ceremony of the Nanjing 2014 Summer Youth Olympic Games. We're at the Nanjing Olympic Sports Center Stadium. We've all experienced a wonderful 12 days of competition and enjoyed some very special and sometimes spectacular performances by the participants in this second edition of the IOC's youth flagship multi-sport event. But the most enduring memories will be of a city which opened its doors with extraordinary hospitality and humility, of a country with such a rich cultural heritage, declaring its ambition to be at the forefront of peace and prosperity in the world, and of facilitating the opportunity for thousands of young ambassadors to create international relationships that will last a lifetime. We're inside the stadium now, and the athletes right in front of us have already come in. They've been here for about 45 minutes right now.
These are the athletes who've embodied the spirit of the Youth Olympic Games, showing us the characteristics of young people worldwide who are enthusiastic about the future and what it holds. Over 3,800 participants have competed in the spirit of friendly rivalry, whilst having respect for each other's efforts and truly appreciating performances from fellow athletes from all countries.
They've had a marvellous time, and the cameras have certainly been well used.
Mesdames et messieurs,
here is the arrival of the VIPs then for the closing ceremony.
Le Conseil des Affaires d'État de la République Populaire de Chine, Li Keqiang, et le président du Comité International Olympique, Thomas Bach.
So His Excellency Li Keqiang, the Premier of the People's Republic of China, plus the President of the International Olympic Committee. He has been so busy these last 12 days, Mr. Thomas Bach. This wonderfully atmospheric stadium with the lights, the music, and this wonderful and beautiful setting for what will be a solemn affair. Of course, closing ceremonies always are, but definitely there will be fun and laughter to go with it. There is His Excellency Li Keqiang. Just listen to the crowd's response to his arrival. Thomas Bach has had a... There's Li Keqiang, but Thomas Bach has had a most wonderful, wonderful time here in Nanjing. He tells us it's his best time ever. the big countdown, 3, 2, 1. And the closing ceremony is officially underway in an absolute cacophony of noise and this wonderful colour and excitement just above the stadium. There will be more fireworks to come later, I can tell you that. And again, the athletes inside this stadium are already seated. We will be getting all the protocol in just a while, but the athletes
et messieurs,
are waiting
bienvenue à la
to be
cérémonie
recognized.
De clôture des Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse d'été de Nanjing 2014.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the closing ceremony of the Nanjing 2014 Summer Youth Olympic Games.
女士们、先生们，欢迎大家来到南京第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会闭幕式现场。
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir les hôtes particuliers pour ce soir, les athlètes des deuxièmes Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our very special guests for this evening, the athletes of the second Youth Olympic Games.
女士们、先生们，让我们用热烈的掌声，向入座在世界荣耀星光方阵的各国家和地区的青年运动员表示欢迎。
And we see the athletes from the Youth Olympic Games being applauded. And here they are. They've had such a wonderful time here in Nanjing. 3,800 participants from 203 countries, 222 events from 28 sports. And not only have they competed in these Youth Olympic Games, but they've also been involved in the cultural exchange, with activities in culture, education and sport to promote Olympism and practice the Olympic values. And I think they can truly say this has been the experience of their life.
No doubt at all about that. We saw Jacques Rogge in one of the cutaways there.
Mesdames et messieurs, le drapeau national de la République populaire de Chine.
Ladies and gentlemen, now the entrance of the national flag of the People's Republic of China.
女士们、先生们，中华人民共和国国旗入场。
So the entry of the national flag of the People's Republic of China. 8 flag bearers from the Honor Guard will be escorting the national flag into the stadium. And it is most extraordinary affair. You can see flanked by the volunteers who really, really respect not only their nation as a whole, but the national flag is something that no one can deny them in terms of their honor to represent. It is something very special in the People's Republic of China. Let no one think otherwise. Red represents revolution initially, and the 5 stars and their relationship represent the unity of the Chinese people. Under the leadership of the Communist Party of China, 5 stars are in yellow. 4 smaller stars, each with 1 point directed at the bigger one in the center, to represent the unity around one center. Underneath the flag, the hoisting of the national flag of the People's Republic of China, will be followed by the national anthem. And just listen to the excitement of the crowd once again. They have contributed so, so much to the success of these wonderful games.
Veuillez vous lever pour le drapeau et l'hymne national de la République populaire de Chine.
Please rise for the national flag and the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.
请起立。 升中华人民共和国国旗，奏唱中华人民共和国国歌。
Les comités nationaux olympiques ayant participé aux deuxième Jeux olympiques de la jeunesse.
Ladies and gentlemen, the flags representing the National Olympic Committees that have participated in the second Youth Olympic Games.
女士们、先生们，第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会闭幕式入场仪式现在开始，欢迎各国家和地区奥委会礼宾旗帜入场。
The parade of flags of the National Olympic Committees now begins, with flags to be carried by an athlete representative chosen by each of the 203 participating nations. In the tradition of all Olympic Games, the Greek flag will be the first to enter the stadium.Many of the flag bearers have produced outstanding performances. From Great Britain in gymnastics, Gianni Regini Moran, 3 gold, 2 bronze in the men's artistic gymnastics. Luca van den Kiebos carries the Belgian flag. Linoy Ashram for rhythmic gymnastics for Israel. And in rhythmic gymnastics, of course, the Russian Federation did so well. Irina Anenkova winning the all-around and the Russian Federation winning the group all-around.And other gymnastic performances, Dylan Schmidt from New Zealand, the first medalist from New Zealand in trampoline.
As well as the individual NOCs being represented, the great thing about the Youth Olympic Games and the IOC's ambition is that there would be mixed competition as well, both mixed gender and also mixed continents and countries andA couple of examples of that, the Asia-Oceania team, actually they played in fencing, which of course was Mr. Buck's favorite sport. In fact, he was a gold medalist as an Olympic athlete. And on that occasion, it was Hong Kong, South Korea and Japan that teamed up to beat Europe 30-26. Judo as well had mixed team.France were involved there and they just beat Serbia, Chinese Taipei. But in fact, it was a really, really interesting ambition. And in fact, there haven't been any league tables for these competitions. Rather, just individual sports that have teamed up with a lot of very, very ambitious young people. And some countries who never, ever have a chance.Of getting a medal, have teamed up and managed that because they've been matched up with people who have been much more talented and experienced.
Some of the sports have used different formats, such as hockey, who've used hockey fives, and that's been a fast and furious game. And all the competitors have been so fit and strong in this particular discipline.In the women, the Chinese were victorious, and in the men, the Australians. And another sport which actually had modified rules was basketball 3-on-3, which everybody was thrilled to watch. USA in the women doing very well then, and in the men, actually, it was Lithuania who came out on top.
Don't you love the way the volunteers are showing the athletes how to wave the flag and how to keep the pace? It's all clockwork stuff here, trying to keep to time. And of course, the Chinese absolutely dominated the field in their favorite sports, badminton and table tennis as well. In badminton, in fact, we've got the Chinese flag carrier, Shi Yuqi, who won an extraordinary men's singles match against Lin Weipu, again his compatriot. But the match of the badminton series is no question, Herbing Chao against Akane Yamaguchi of Japan. It was the most exhausting to watch and certainly to play. It was a fantastic match. Bing Zhao had never won before. Two junior world champions, championships Yamaguchi had won, and Bing Zhao came through so strongly. It was the same story in table tennis. Liu Baoyang and Fang Zhendong came through as the women's and the men's champion and just displayed superb, absolutely superb skills throughout. Still got the march in of the flags and the bearers. For the United States, it's Richelle Stevens, female rugby player. And for the Cook Isles, I will mention them because this is one of the smallest nations. Memory Akama played golf for the women's team for the Cook Islands. It's just so wonderful to see so many here. And of course, Russian, very, very strong. The Russian Federation representative here for judo, Mikhail Igolinikov. There are so many people to talk about, so many things to report. I hope you will read on and look on for a long time to come. It's been a fantastic, fantastic Games.
Some of the flag bearers come from some of the smaller nations. The Virgin Islands, US, we have Ajay Sweeney, who was in beach volleyball, and that was a marvelous event with the Russia in the men dominating and the Canadian women coming out on top. The marvellous thing to see is all of these flag bearers representing so many different sports.
Not as precise as others. You can see just little wavering and trying to keep them in line is very, very difficult. But of course, this last evening is all about celebration as well as not wanting to leave. So many people have said they've had such a magnificent time. We've got quotes aplenty here. Rosie Davidson, a middle distance runner from Australia, she said, "I'm so, so sad to leave. This has been an amazing trip. I enjoyed this more than I could ever, ever believe, and I really don't want to go home." Isn't that a wonderful thing to say?
He Xiangkong from China, the race walker, said, "It's a precious once-in-a-lifetime experience. In addition to the racing, I've harvested many precious souvenirs featuring different cultures from the athletes. And the yogging that went on in the village was fantastic. The sharing of knowledge through the little yog dongles that they were trying to match friendships with and collect how many people they could."
The great thing is the IOC have insisted, because they underwrote the whole athletes assembling here, that all the athletes, even if they were on the first day of competition and finished their event, they stayed till the end. That is so different from the other Olympic Games. This has been definitely a combination of a test of their talent and obviously their gamesmanship and the ability to be able to compete, but also, even more importantly in some respects, the study of the cultural and the educational program was very, very much to the fore for the IOC. And just look at the way the crowd are greeting the cameraman that's coming past them at the moment. They really are so excited. Stars definitely in the stands as well as on the parade area in front of us.
I think one of the other products of the athletes staying on was how many we saw go to other events and support not only their athletes, but athletes from other countries as well. And we saw some marvellous examples. The men's high bar final, where the final gymnast from Great Britain was performing, and the Russian and the American gymnasts were cheering him on, hoping that he would do his best routine. And I think that's been the spirit of these games.
It has been phenomenal. Even last evening, coming home from the hockey, I was witness to Some Australians celebrating the victory, of course, in their men's team. But they filled up the bus, and then right in the corner I spotted where I sat a couple of Italian youngsters who were talking in English to the Russian who had just beaten them on the beach volleyball court for ninth place to eighth place. And they were very animated in their appreciation of each other and wondering where they came from, what they were doing. It is the atmosphere that is so, so wonderful about these Youth Olympics. Georgian flag on the right of screen there. Still the parade of these flags, and of course all the athletes are there on the lower tier, you can see right in front, so they're getting the perfect view of their countries being represented here. It is very, very special. And the great thing is they're all together. It's not as individuals, they're all coming together.
The great spirit of the athletes has also spread through to the coaches, the spectators, the volunteers, the man in the street. It's just been the most amazing atmosphere around these Youth Olympic Games in every single sport.
Well, Nanjing has pulled out all the stops. Never have we seen such dedicated volunteers. They'll be honoured a little bit later on, of course, but everywhere we've been, it's been the smile, it's been the gratitude for us coming. Huh, can you imagine? We're so privileged to be here, and they're thanking us for coming. It's quite amazing. When you consider the history, wonderful, rich history of Nanjing, it was the former capital, of course, had really, really tough times. Not too many decades ago, they had some very, very tough times back in the 30s and into the 40s. But they've risen from that difficulty, and just look at the celebration of expectation of things to come. The future is very, very bright. Now in position for the next phase of the protocol element of the closing ceremony.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez souhaiter la bienvenue aux représentants des volontaires des Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse de Nanjing 2014.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the representatives of the volunteers for Nanjing 2014 Summer Youth Olympic Games.
女士们、先生们。 欢迎本届青奥会志愿者代表入场。
To honour the volunteers, we have six volunteer representatives who've been chosen. The theme is Inspire Three Generations. The volunteers have put in countless hours. Some tasks are behind the scenes, and all have completed their duties in a friendly and helpful way.
Au nom de tous les athlètes, des fleurs aux représentants des milliers de volontaires des Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse de Nanjing 2014 pour les remercier d'avoir fait de ces Jeux une expérience merveilleuse.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes who will present flowers on behalf of all athletes to thank the thousands of volunteers who have made the Games of Nanjing 2014 a wonderful experience.
女士们、先生们，欢迎运动员代表为志愿者代表献花，感谢成千上万的志愿者，使他们的辛勤工作让本届青奥会更加精彩。
Outstanding young athletes are presenting flowers to the volunteers in honour of all the work that they've done. We can't put on an event like this without a large volunteer base, and we've seen young and old all very happy to perform their duties for the honour and the smooth running of these Youth Olympic Games.
I tell you, it's become tradition now for those volunteers to be honoured. And I tell you, these deserve special honour for the amount of time and
Mesdames
effort and energy.
Mesdames et messieurs, durant ces 12 derniers jours, les athlètes participants aux Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse de Nanjing ont vécu une expérience unique et exceptionnelle, partageant les valeurs olympiques d'excellence, d'amitié et de respect. Maintenant, veuillez accueillir Shen Duo, jeune athlète chinoise en natation, qui va lire au nom de tous les participants à ces Jeux l'engagement pris par les athlètes pour le futur.
Ladies and gentlemen, during the past 12 days, the athletes participating in the Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing have shared a unique and incredible experience, lived the Olympic values of excellence, friendship and respect. Tonight, please welcome Shen Duo, a young athlete from China in swimming, who, on behalf of all the participants here at these games, will read the athlete's pledge for the future.
This is the first time that the athlete's commitment, the athlete's pledge, will be read by one of the athletes. Chen Duo will be the one who's chosen from swimming to represent all the athletes and commitment to the principles and the ideals of the Youth Olympic movement.
我代表所有青年奥林匹克运动员承诺，无论赛场内外，均担任体育大使的角色，诠释冠军的真正含义。青年奥林匹克运动会激励着我们利用体育的力量来创造一个更加美好、更加和平的世界。 现在轮到我们发挥榜样作用，传递青奥精神，鼓励更多年轻人践行奥林匹克价值观。谢谢大家。So
the commitment to be inspired by the values of Olympism.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir le président du comité d'organisation des Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse de Nanjing, Li Xueyong. Et le président du comité international olympique, Thomas Parr, champion olympique d'escrime en 1976.
Ladies and gentlemen, president of the Nanjing Youth Olympic Games Organizing Committee, Li Xueyong, and president of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Parr, Olympic champion, fencing, 1976.
女士们、先生们，欢迎第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会组织委员会主席李学勇。
So Li Xueyong, the organizing president, together with the IOC president, Thomas Bach, will deliver a speech and then the declaration of the closing of Nanjing 2014. Li Xueyong, on the left, has done a magnificent job as the president of the Nanjing organizing committee for these second Youth Olympic Games. It has been a daunting task, but they've spared absolutely nothing in order to bring the athletes and the media, I have to say, together for a marvelous occasion. Nice touch from Thomas Bach there, congratulating Chen Duo. So, President Li Xueyong.
尊敬的李克强总理，尊敬的巴赫主席和夫人，尊敬的各位来宾。 女士们，先生们，
He's addressed
青少年朋友们
obviously the President Thomas Bach and Mrs. Bach, distinguished guests. Tonight marks the conclusion of all sports and competitions, the end of Nanjing 2014 Summer Youth Olympic Games. It's a moment to celebrate friendship, to revel in the success of these games. He says, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the International Olympic Committee, the International Sports Federations, and the National Olympic Committees, everyone who's contributed to the Games. Over the past 12 days, young athletes from across the five continents competed in various sports, new friends, and fulfilled their dreams. He's congratulated them for all their great performances. Win or lose, they have learnt a huge amount about themselves. Looking back at our journey of preparing for and hosting the Games, we want to thank all those involved in the preparation and smooth operation of the Games for their brilliant ideas and hard work. Coupled with that must be Chen Weiya, the director and creative director of the opening and closing ceremonies. Thoughtful services and cheerful smiles leave our guests with many beautiful memories. Our gratitude also goes to friends from the media who shared the Games, moving stories and memorable moments with people all over the world. Our joint efforts have made the Games spectacular and unforgettable, opening a new chapter for the Olympic movement. Dear friends of Nanjing 2014, it's a new beginning for the Youth Olympic Games. Let's start from here with cherished hope and dreams to promote the Olympic spirit and build a better future. It's now my great privilege. The Olympic spirit will build a better future for all of us. It's now my great privilege to invite IOC President Thomas Bach to deliver a speech. Mr. Li Shuiyong, after many, many years of dedication to this event.
Thank you, Nanjing.
Thank you, Nanjing.
Your Excellency, Mr. Li Keqiang, Premier of the People's Republic of China, Excellencies, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, dear young athletes, chers jeunes athlètes, you are the future of the Olympic movement. Vous êtes l'avenir du mouvement olympique. You have competed with determination. Vous avez concouru avec détermination. You have shown respect for your opponents and the rules. Vous vous êtes montré respectueux de vos concurrents et des règles. You have shared with others. and learned from others in the Youth Olympic Village. You have given us a glimpse of your bright future and the bright future of the Olympic movement. You have made many friends around our globe for the last 12 days. Jogging helped, and the selfies were awesome. Now it is about this Olympic community we have built. It is about the many friends we all made. So again, I ask everybody here in this stadium, get your smartphones out. But do not take a selfie tonight. In the Olympic spirit, greet and thank the person next to you and take their picture. Share this token of friendship with the world and post it with the hashtag Nanjing2014. These Summer Youth Olympic Games were a resounding success, thanks to our wonderful Chinese hosts. All of us from every corner of the world would like to thank the government and the people of China, Changzhou and Nanjing. We would like to say thank you to the thousands of volunteers. You are also part of this bright future that we have seen here in Nanjing. You have reached out to us and to the whole world. We want to respond to you. Thank you. Thank you very much, dear volunteers. The organization of these games was perfectly flawless. The organizing committee has set a great example for sustainable organization by making use of a legacy and by leaving another great legacy to the people of Nanjing, Jiangsu and China. I would like to thank all our Chinese hosts. With your already world-famous efficiency and with your overwhelming friendliness, you have made all of us feel at home here in Nanjing, this great ancient city, this modern and dynamic city, capital of the Yangzhou province. Only some of these young athletes can return home with a medal. But all of you can return home knowing that you did your very best. This is why you all can be happy. And this is why we all are so proud of you. So take the spirit of the Nanjing Summer Youth Olympic Games home. Share it with your families, friends, and schoolmates. Tell everybody about your new friends. Tell everybody about the great diversity of cultures you experienced. Tell everybody about your great passion for sport. Live up to the pledge you just made. On behalf of the entire Olympic movement and on behalf of Olympic people from 204 countries and territories, I say, Xiexie Nanjing! Xiexie Zhongguo! Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. Now is the moment when I have to say farewell and to declare the Summer Youth Olympic Games Nanjing 2014 closed. At the same time,
literally, his thunder was stolen by the extraordinary explosions above our heads. The dramatic skyline of Nanjing lit up. Fantastic fireworks, the home of fireworks, China. Thomas Bach has not quite finished yet. And I tell you, the moment when he declared it closed was a very poignant moment for the people of the city of Nanjing.
At the same time, it is a happy opportunity to invite the next generation of athletes to Buenos Aires, Argentina, 10,018.
Thomas Bach knows the journey all these athletes have embarked upon and is very committed to the Youth Olympic Games and to helping athletes achieve their ambitions. We've seen him at many events encouraging the athletes and enjoying their performances.
Here's now the Olympic anthem and the lowering of the Olympic flag. The cauldron will not be extinguished quite yet, but these are very, very sad moments for many people here in Nanjing. Everyone in the crowd would support every word that Thomas Bach had to say there. It's been an extraordinary experience for every one of us.
坐下。
The music written by Spiridon Samaras. Now, a little look at some of the competition here in Nanjing.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie de remise du drapeau olympique. Veuillez accueillir le président du comité international olympique, Doma Bar, et le maire de Nanjing, Miao Ruiling.
Ladies and gentlemen, now the handover of the Olympic flag. Please welcome President of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Bar, and Mayor of Nanjing, Miao Ruiling.
The handover of the Olympic flag from Nanjing to the IOC will shortly occur.
This
is a traditional ceremony with the passing of the flag from one host to the next host occurs. Onto the podium. It's passed to the mayor of Nanjing, Miao Ruiling. He waves the flag from side to side four times and passes it to Thomas Bach, the IOC president, who also waves the flag four times.IOC will keep possession of the flag to present later to the mayor of Buenos Aires, where the third Summer Youth Olympic Games will be held.
Very shortly we're going to be having a video presented by Buenos Aires, the host in 2018.
Vení a Buenos Aires, sede de los Juegos Olímpicos de la Juventud 2018.
Now the hoisting of the national flag of Argentina and the playing of the national anthem of Argentina.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour le drapeau national et l'hymne national de l'Argentine.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national flag and national anthem of Argentina.
女士们，先生们。请起立，升阿根廷国旗，奏阿根廷国歌。 请坐下。
Some of the wonderful experiences that the Youth Olympic Games here in Nanjing has offered, both in the Olympic Village and also out and about in the city itself. It's been quite a phenomenal opportunity. Wouldn't you love your son or daughter to experience this? On the wall of Nanjing, something very special, even trying some of the original instruments. There is so much to do and see in Nanjing. Imperial Examination Center, going back in history some 1800 years, but then opportunities for all the people who've come here to visit this city to be involved in some way or another, contributing not just to the life of Nanjing, but to the life of each other. Classes in different sports, and certainly try a bit of pottery as well. Whoever thought they could be having all these cultural and educational experiences, it's just been quite phenomenal. Something to tell the world, as they are now real Olympism ambassadors. The rhythm, every country, 204 nations represented here at the Youth Olympic Games. And just look at the fantastic, fantastic experience they've had.
messieurs, profitez maintenant du spectacle de la cérémonie de clôture Youth in Full Bloom.
Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy the performance for the closing ceremony, Youth in Full Bloom.
And now it's time for the entertainment side of the closing ceremony, as is expected. The party now starts, and it's an opportunity for the athletes to enjoy the entertainment and to reflect on their experiences in Nanjing. We'll start with a square tablet screen on the centre of the stadium, and the little Nanjing girl is playing. Swipe the screen, and in the center we see letters of the Nanjing former shape. We see some aerial performers, 50 meters up, 150 meter cables stretching across the stadium. The letters of Nanjing appear on stages. First and last letters in the Nanjing are arch-like shapes, and they symbolize the ancient city wall gates. Warm welcome to the young people of the world. Happy reunion, good health, and also symbolizing being the home of the Youth Olympic Games. You see those wonderful aerial athletes. 50 meters above the ground, come diving down. Each of the letters is on a giant stage where we see the performances unfold.
Letter N for Nanjing stands up, symbolizing the gate of Nanjing as well, open for all to come through and celebrate in song and music, and of course, very much action as well, bursting with youthful vigor. The song is City of Youth. Singers Han Shui, Guo Liang, Sun Yama. Every letter of Nanjing being given a focal podium point for this high-octane dance and rhythm. Certainly the story of the youth in Nanjing is now forever etched on our memories. Cheerleaders, acrobats, and really the whole theme is based on celebration of a fantastic job well done here in Nanjing. It's not just China that's hosted. Nanjing, the proud city, former capital, is now with a population of over 8 million. I think it's 8.2 million now. It's really, really gathering its momentum to become one of the great destinations of Asia. You should come and see it.
And this section is good wishes for tomorrow. And a few athletes from different parts of the world walk out of the crowd. One of them swipes the screen and he writes down in his diary, "Tomorrow I'll leave Nanjing." Song Tomorrow sings out all the young athletes' reluctance to say goodbye to this wonderful city. Carlo Asprey from Canada is singing this song, the lyrics by Yu Yuri.
I'm 星辰坐庙浏览，我在心里把你呼唤。
Well, tomorrow we certainly will be all spread around the globe, all of us, media as well as the athletes, many of the performers. And I tell you, this rather sad song, you have to say, called Tomorrow, will certainly be very, very high on our memory list as the regrets pop into our lives. Maybe we regret we didn't perform as well as we'd hoped, but certainly the thankful moments that we met all our new friends. And we might part, but we'll certainly be very close for a long time.
Nanjing Qingyao It's an honor! Belongs to you!
Again, this is now big time as we rev up the amps once more.
And now we have a song which is a little bit more joyful called I Believe. Believing we'll meet again and embrace a beautiful future. And this is all about the athletes knowing that somewhere in the future their paths will cross again. Maybe at another international event, maybe at the Olympic Games, or maybe just catching up with old friends in many years to come. Music is by Chen Guohua, singer Yang Peian. You see here a great combination of action, rhythmic gymnastics, acrobatics, the mountain biking, which shows the strength of the youth, and also some of the sports of the future, traditional sports of China. The Youth Olympic Games also showing the youth of the world the fun of being active and healthy and participating in many activities. And there we see Mengjing Lele, multiples, mascot of the Youth Olympic Games. Lele means happiness in Mandarin, and it also refers to the sound of stones banging. And Mengjing Lele was inspired by the rainflower pebble, which is a little bit ironic because it's raining right now.
Had the moments of precipitation, and here once again we've got a little more water, and that will add of course to the opportunity for the youth to full bloom as we start a new item called Happy Family. Just in time, the water in projection meets the water from the heavens. Here's the Chinese flute. The bamboo flute with Ma Shui. Confucius Temple here in Nanjing, initially built in the first year of the Emperor Qing Yu's reign of the Song Dynasty, 1034, a place to worship and offer sacrifices to Confucius. It's a wonderful temple, and Nanjing is very proud of its associations with Confucius, of course. Great tourist attraction. Celebration. Again, youth in full bloom. We're going to see the flower, flower-shaped lanterns as well. Lots of folk music. The more traditional side of Nanjing. Traditional music. This is the percussion, the Nanjing Little Red Flower Art Troupe. And here, glittering lotus lanterns of the Confucius Temple drift in from all directions. Lively little fish frolic and splash in the water. The Confucius Temple certainly is for the whole family. And it's a place where people go to check their fortune maybe, but also to spend some quiet time and to contemplate the future as well as the past. It does have a wonderful spirit, a wonderful atmosphere. Thank you. the director of music, actually. He's got a wonderful sense of humour. Zhang Beng. He gave us a demonstration also at the media press conference for this closing ceremony, and he was quite stunning. Live entertainment for us all. Traditional instrument. As we now get the colourful edition of Cycles, and just look at this celebration of fun. Merry song and glittering the lanterns bring the spectators to a warm, happy family in the area. Of course, it's right by the Yangtze River here in Nanjing. Of course, it's been used not just as a place for fishing, but also for irrigation and for access to the sea for travel overseas to far away places. Ancient music with a modern twist, and look at this. Oh, you cannot believe it. That is so brave. That is a huge surprise. The creator of the music is sky high. Beautiful.
Clear the stadium. We now hear the song Halo, sung by Jack Junyi. The Olympic flame still burning brightly. These young people come through. Reflection of the Olympic rings, multiple forms. A stunning and colourful backdrop to this song. Performance of stylized martial arts in the background shows a very strong tradition that China has in the performing arts, acrobatics and gymnastics. So well spread across the whole world. Think I'm addicted to your lie. I swear I'll never fall again. But this don't even feel like falling. Gravity can't forget to pull me back to the ground again. Feels like I've been the weekend. Every rule I had to break, I end. There is still I'm taking. I am never gonna shock you. And the ribbons of the Olympic rings colours are projected onto the stage. And you see now the ribbons rising up into the air. Felix Rubin, acrobats. Stunning lighting display, 2,500 lighting devices in the stadium, projecting these wonderful colours.
Ethereal sound with those ribbons going to the sky once again, but looking outside in, the rain has eased off a little. Now, we're going across the five continents with a mood of carnival. We've friends all over the world, and the youth from the five continents dance with the passion to show their vitality, fulfill their dreams, and jointly build the global dream. Prizes for guessing where we started. Where are we going now? Feel the energy in the crowd rising with this high-octane dance. I think we go to the Middle East for a short time.
popular tune from Australia, representing the Oceania region. Clip go the shears.
That sounds a little like Spain to me. Rhythms are on us right now. Have we got South America? Buenos Aires, we're going to be coming there soon. Of course, the Olympic Games also in Rio de Janeiro in 2016. We've got a lot of time to watch South America. China Oriental Performing Arts Group. They're all native of China, so haven't they done a wonderful job in representing the other continents of the world? Volunteers have been magnificent. We've said it so many times, but their duty, the way in which they've had so many boring jobs supposedly, but they've done it with such cheerful style. The young girls that were helping to present the prizes, the guys rolling up the mats and the presentation dais, and well, of course, the ever-present Lele. They have all volunteered and they've all done a magnificent job. They should all be very proud of their contribution. Tears of sadness at leaving each other, I can tell you, that's what it's about.
Towards the end of the games, we saw so many of the volunteer teams taking photos, and they've made friends as well, and they will never forget their experiences here at the Youth Olympic Games.
This item is called Loving Heart, and you can understand why.
Volunteers stream in onto the stage area, and we're going to have a lot of fun with this next activity. So this is the song Chinese Card, and the singer Ping An. We have more than 500 volunteers from the Jiangsu Police Institute and the Nanjing Forest Police College, and they've been involved in both the ceremonies and performances.
Yeah, yeah.
special way the song Chinese Card to send a message of loving heart to the world and to show their attachment to Nanjing 2014. Volunteers have been the special glue that's held this most magnificent Olympic Games together. Chinese letters or symbols showing a Chinese card, sending a message of loving heart to the world.
Some of the great action, five-a-side hockey there, marvellous athletic events as well, triumphant, some there, France against Argentina did brilliantly well to win the gold, Argentina silver medalists, and some wonderful, wonderful play in the volleyball and badminton court, and in the swimming pool. It has been a stunning, stunning performance by everyone in the gymnastics, and there, three goals for that young fella. And then, how much fun was that, the slam dunk competition, and then an extraordinary performance by her to win the gold. We had some fantastic kayaks, we had some fabulous taekwondo and judo, and women's rugby. It was just non-stop action for all of us. Just a reminder of what we've just witnessed over the past 12 days. It has been stunning. And now, of course, after all the excitement, there is a moment of poignancy, a moment we've all really been dreading, when we have to extinguish the flame that has kept us company on the north side of this fabulous and spectacular stadium for the last 12 days. It is tough. It does bring a lump to the throat and a tear to the eye, and the music is totally appropriate. This song, Youthful Memories. Like to say farewell, particularly when we've had such a wonderful time together. The Latin American dance we see performed before us, just a reminder of where maybe we will end up. Absolutely stunning voices working in harmony, just like so many of the young people we've seen here over the last 12 days. The cauldron high on the north stand of the stadium. Took a short, brief look at it there, but it will be extinguished very soon. Eventually die in Nanjing, it will be given rebirth again very shortly, very, very soon in Buenos Aires, the ambition and hope of a new cycle of Youth Olympics will begin once again. So out of the ashes of this cauldron here in Nanjing will come a new and wonderful ambition again. And the family we saw early in the closing ceremony returns to witness the moments that we really don't want to see. But of course, every wonderful thing has to come to an end at some stage. The selfie with the flame in the background. And there, slowly, it will disappear from our eyes. The emotion of this moment, every single time, draws a tear and a lump in the throat. Well done, Nanjing. But, as I've just explained, it's the end of Nanjing's experience, but it's the rebirth of the South American experience, and Buenos Aires can look forward to renewal of something very special. Carnival of Youth now, and the theme song, Light Up the Future, now that we've extinguished the flame of Nanjing.
为今春影的所有精彩，我在天地之间呼唤爱，看地成影我眼睛。 Young people singing for the youth, filled with fond dreams for the future. And it's a spectacular celebration of the Chinese dream, the youth dream, and the global dream. The large figures in the background, in colours of the Olympic rings. This night of carnival will certainly be remembered by all. And friends from all over the world will remember the smiling face of Nanjing Lele. And Nanjing Lele takes to the skies.
And underneath her is this wonderful, wonderful ability to take the paintings from all the children of Nanjing higher up into the sky so they can all be seen again. They've all contributed enormously in the education system to the celebration of Nanjing 2014. It's a spectacular, wonderful vision that we have here, and even joined by some of the butterflies from the opening ceremony.
The colours used in the design for Nanjing Lele are from the emblem of Nanjing 2014, and the purpose of the design is to promote among young people all over the world a happy and healthy lifestyle. This is a great example for people all over the world how to celebrate life.
Fly, 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 青春不再。
Everyone showing enthusiasm for the spectacular display, colour and energy of all our performers here during this closing ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of the closing ceremony of Nanjing 2014 Summer Youth Olympic Games. Good night.
女士们、先生们, 南京第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会闭幕式到此结束。 祝大家晚安。
The kaleidoscope of colour and the vitality of performance shows that we can still look forward to the rebirth of all that's best in the Summer Youth Olympic Games. 4 years' time in Buenos Aires will have exactly that. Here in Nanjing, it has quite simply been a wonderful celebration of all that is good and wholesome and inspirational about the gathering of highly talented and highly motivated young people in a place that has been the perfect host, Nanjing. Those who reach for the stars will always bring optimism and joy to all of us who are more modest in our ambitions. But Nanjing 2014 has showed us that we can all share in the dream of peace and prosperity in the world by being Youth Olympic Friends for Life. Xie xie ni Nanjing and Zai Xian. Yeah.